meant for an adult audience. Loveline may contain sexually oriented content. Listener discretion is advised.
Loveline with Adam Carolla and Dr. Drew.
Hey, everybody, it's Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Dr. Drew, board-certified physician, addiction medicine specialist. Drew went to Salt Lake City today, everybody.
Yeah, good times.
Yeah? What'd you do?
I gave a talk.
Mm-hmm.
It was good. Really was fun.
Then you came home?
Then I came home.
Nice. Sounds like a pain in the ass. Did they pay you?
Yeah, of course.
Nice. All right. Feeling good enough for that.
I'm sort of, as long as I can sit down and lie down and stuff periodically, I'm pretty good shape right now.
Mm-hmm.
But I by the end of talking, I'd have a stool up there so I could sit down. My sort of lower abdomen and nuts ached like a mother F.
Really?
Yeah.
Drew's nuts ached there, but
yeah, it was not fun.
All right. But he's in good enough shape to go get a paycheck in Salt Lake City.
I'm here, am I not?
I don't know. Sometimes I ask myself that same question, Drew. I don't know. I like when people do that.
Where's Dr. Drew?
Sarah?
Yeah?
You're 13?
Mm-hmm.
What's that?
I was wondering, my boyfriend, he's 22, mm-hmm. and we've been dating for 2 months, and I was wondering if that's illegal.
Yes.
If you've had sex, I imagine. I'll check the Missouri statutes, but
I'm guessing Missouri's somewhere between zygote and fetus. Drew, is that when it's illegal there? Statutory laws?
Missouri.
See?
No. Zygote's you go to jail.
Oh, zygote.
Yeah. Fetus.
As embryo and
embryo, fetus. Embryo's okay. Fetus, good.
Okay.
Zygote, no. Sorry.
All right.
Morula, no.
Hey, is it, what do you start? Is it an embryo? Go to a zygote?
No, we're sort of messing around with terms.
Zygote
is the...
Don't bore me. Sarah, just laugh. Laugh it up.
You're very funny.
Thank you.
How old do you have to be, though?
What's up? Hold on a second. I did this photo shoot with Jimmy today.
Yeah.
And he's doing some photo shoot for Esquire magazine.
Oh.
And I guess Jimmy has narcolepsy.
God, it's 14.
It's 14 in Missouri?
Yeah, she's 13.
They must have raised it recently, too.
Anyway, yeah.
Jimmy, they're doing a photo shoot. And so the idea of this is I was going to be the guest on the show because they didn't have any other celebrities roaming around the building. And Jimmy was going to pretend like he was passed out asleep on his desk. We shot it on his set this afternoon. And so they said, well, Adam, you just, sit in the guest chair. They put the makeup on and everything. You gesture your hands around. Just tell us a story. Go on a rant. Do one of your rant things. And Jimmy, you just lie there and put your head down. So I started ranting about people picking me up and showing up too early and ringing the buzzer and waking me up and blah, blah, blah. And Jimmy was kind of, and once in a while, he'd break and chuckle and stuff like that because I was going on a good rant. And then when we're done, he goes, must be tough to go on these long rants and have just someone holding still with their head down and not responding. I said, I work with Drew and Ann. I work with Tara, don't call me Tara and Ann. I work with these people every night. Are you kidding me? I didn't even notice. It wasn't uncomfortable to me at all. That's why I'm used to working.
Now, where did the narcolepsy come in? Did he actually fall asleep?
No, he has narcolepsy, evidently. And that was they're trying to get the photo shoot
I see.
Him sleeping.
He does not have narcolepsy.
Yeah, he's got something.
What the hell?
Shut up. Sarah?
Yeah?
All right. So, 22-year-old guy you're dating.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us about him.
What?
Tell us about him.
He
must be quite a gem.
What?
He must be quite a gem.
I can't hear you. Say it again?
Tell us about
the guy.
Oh, well, he works at Taco Bell. I know, it's kind of pathetic. He's a really nice guy, though.
Mm-hmm.
And I was, talking, though, and he's like, I wonder if it's illegal or not.
Have you...
We both listened to the show, and he said it caught us.
Have you had any physical contact with him?
Yeah.
What have you done with him?
We had sex once.
All right, well, there you go.
He's a criminal. Does his cuticles smell like onions?
No.
All right, because when you work at Taco Bell, your fingers are going to smell beanie.
Yeah.
Hey, Sarah?
Mm-hmm.
See, in my world, if a girl is 13 and a guy is 22, that's illegal. A what?
A girl? Oh, boy. Go ahead.
Drew, I say 7,000 words to every one of your crappy words.
All right, fair enough.
Jesus Christ. I, that's my pet peeve. I can't stand that.
What's that?
Well, if I'm mispronouncing the word girl, then you should correct me.
I did.
Yeah, every time. If you make a mistake, you make
I see.
I'm saying. If I'm walking and I have no difficulty walking, but
trip.
I catch a crack,
yeah.
You don't have to start laughing and go, you don't know how to walk. No, something happened.
Fair enough.
Jesus Christ. A girl at...
All right. So the girl
Sarah.
13.
I don't even know where I was anymore. Here's what I'm saying. If he works at Taco Bell, I will deduct 8 years from his age. Do you understand? Emotionally. And it'll be okay for you two to date, okay?
But in the eyes of the law, you can't have sex
right.
with him.
This is illegal. You understand?
Okay. And I just, again, the thing I try to coach young women about is when you get to be 22 and you think about a guy your own age dating somebody who's an eighth grader, your skin will crawl.
Yeah.
That guy is not the guy you want a 13-year-old dating.
That's ironic.
That's the ultimate irony, isn't it?
She's going to be, when she's 22, she will have an eighth grader. I've done
inside
the math.
Insider?
No.
So to speak?
No, I mean, I think she's going to give birth tomorrow. And
oh,
it's just
going to
work
She'll
out
have
perfectly.
An eighth grader. Yes. Yeah,
work out
right.
perfectly.
Good times.
Jessica?
Yes.
You're 29.
Yes.
What's up?
My question is for Dr. Drew. It's about orgasms.
Okay.
I don't believe that I've ever had one. And I've been married for... about 4.5 years. I have 3 kids, and I don't know if there's something wrong with me or if that's normal or...
At 29, you should have sort of figured that out by now.
Well, you would think so.
You should have something that approximate an orgasm by mid-20s.
Yeah, and I don't know. I mean, is it normal? Is there people that just don't?
Yeah, there are. There are, and they're not men. They're women.
Yeah, I would figure
that. But except other than that, they're all the same.
Right.
Except for that. And have you ever sort of worked on this with your husband?
You know, I've had past boyfriends before I ever got married that, you know, would get frustrated, and I would just be like, you know, it's not you. I know it's me, and I don't know how to fix it. You know, I don't know. It's a very frustrating thing. My husband doesn't get frustrated anymore because he just knows, you know, not to pressure me or try to, you know, he knows me good enough to know that, you know, it's just not going to happen.
Hold on a second. Jessica sounds like a real hurried person.
Yeah, she's very anxious. Yeah.
Now, she could be on the radio, maybe. She's a little anxious from that, but she sounds uptight.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, she's not going to have an orgasm because of that.
She can't release.
Yeah. Jessica.
I mean, you could be right. I don't know.
Are you on any medication?
What was that?
Are you on any medication?
Not at all.
Okay. And has he ever done oral sex on you?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yes.
Mm-hmm. And you get close?
You know, there's times I think I'm close, and it just, I don't know. I'm like, you know, I was going to ask my gynecologist, but I was so embarrassed I didn't want to ask.
No, you should. That's something they can help you work on.
Really?
Yeah.
What can they tell? I mean, I don't know. It's so embarrassing.
If your gynecologist is some old Indian guy, don't talk to him about
no,
it. That's
no,
going to
get
weird.
He's very nice. I mean.
He's nice?
Yeah.
Well,
he's delivered 3 of my children. I, you know.
Okay.
I trust
right.
him. I trust him.
Okay. So, what about masturbating, like in a tub?
Or with the vibrator, something like that.
I tried that previously, but I have not. That was before I had children. That was before I ever got married, even.
Well, that was such an unpleasant experience.
No, to me, it was kind of dirty, and I just didn't really think. I was like, you know, I don't know. It's just something I myself.
Hey.
What?
Chachana. Hold on, let me talk to Drew in India.
Okay.
Yeah, not itcha.
Itcha nana.
Nana kake, I want na itcha.
Hey, yata.
Hey! All right. Drew's gibberish even sounds like gibberish. All right. Here's what we figured out.
Okay.
You're uptight. You got some stuff going on. You know, you feel like you're mommy now, your wife. It's naughty to do these things.
Maybe, yeah.
Did you have a lot of those sorts of messages when you were growing up?
You know,
No,
listen. I was brought up like kind of strict, and then I went through a very rebellious stage.
Yeah.
And then got pregnant. Mm-hmm. Married the man that got me pregnant, and I mean, we're happy and everything.
Uh oh.
Yeah.
Uh oh.
This is the kind of thing you might want to go into some just sort of traditional psychotherapy.
Married the man that got her pregnant.
No, no,
mean,
no. I don't want to.
Hold on.
No.
All right. Jessica?
You're right. I'm too uptight.
Are you sure you're in love with him?
Yes, I am. At first, I didn't think I was, and I wasn't sure that that it was going to work out, and we hesitated to even get married. And I mean, we waited till our baby was 16 months old.
Yeah.
I wanted to make sure.
All right.
I was still maybe a little hesitant at the time, but
not at all. little basic therapy.
Uh huh.
Yeah, you're wound up a little bit.
Yeah.
Maybe, but I'm nervous because I'm on the phone. I'm always
But we get a little more than that. You're talking about being dirty. And I mean, you really should be sort of figuring this out, both masturbating and with your husband. And sort
you don't smoke pot, do you?
No.
No, it makes you weird, right?
No, my husband used to do a lot. We are so opposite. He was the type that did everything. And I experimented with him a little bit, but didn't do a whole heck of a lot. Because I was kind of, you know... It didn't make me feel good, number one. I just completely lost my mind when I did.
That's what I'm saying.
What do you mean?
You feel panicky.
Maybe, but the first time I did it, I couldn't even drive home. I remember what happened. I ended up at a friend's house and passed out.
All right. It's enough. If you smoke pot, and if you feel like you don't like weed because you feel like you're losing control and you get panic attacks and that kind of stuff, you're usually a high-strung person, and now you're feeling like you've put yourself in a position where you cannot control your feelings, and that's difficult. Interesting.
Like the orgasm is an out-of-control experience, too.
She cannot let herself not be in control of her feelings, when you get altered, especially with weed, it's like you can't control your thoughts and your feelings the way you'd like to.
Yeah.
Interesting.
Perhaps.
Yeah. Perhaps. I could write a goddamn paper. Bill?
Yep.
You're 17?
Yep.
What's up?
All right. The whole deal is I like to go down on my girlfriend, and she just says it doesn't feel good. And I was just wondering, she's 18, and I was just wondering.
So Adam, let me get this right. He insists on going down. She doesn't want it.
Is that true?
No, I don't insist on it. I just like to do it every once in a while. But she just doesn't, it just doesn't feel good for her.
Done.
Could you hang with this guy?
We could hang. Well, as long as he stops,
Does she have orgasms with intercourse, or are you having
sex? Oh, yeah.
Yeah, see, that's...
Our sex is great.
But that is that version of the female, which is the ones that have vaginal, orgasms with vaginal intercourse often don't like or feel sort of uncomfortable with direct clitoral stimulation.
Well, when I, finger, it's fine,
Yeah, that's inside. That's not direct clitoral stimulation.
Okay, so what... Okay, let me float this theory.
Yeah.
Okay. This is interesting. Because this has started to take shape over the last few months and years on this show.
In your mind.
In our mind.
No, I've been pretty clear about this for a while.
You haven't really spoken about it too much.
Yeah. I'll give you the word, we've been talking about it more. All right, go ahead.
You have been talking about it more.
Yeah.
And it's not something we haven't been hearing about this, the vaginal versus the clitoral and the women that are different and how they're different.
You know why? My confidence about that, I've been observing that for years, and I believe that to be the true, but I've tested, I did that Berman and Berman show.
Oh, on the road.
On the television.
Co-eds.
And we had discussions about this, and I was like, you don't like, multiple orgasms, you don't like oral sex, right? So how did you know? Because that's what
true.
That is.
I've heard you make your proclamations many times and your declarations, and no one's ever said how
this
did
was,
you know.
This was at a
they usually
television.
Say, huh?
Yeah.
No? What? Okay. Yeah. This was how long ago you did this?
6-8 months ago.
Yeah. All right. So there you go. Now, could it be that the women are too sensitive? Look at it this way.
Yeah.
Their clitoris is a 100-watt bulb instead of the one... my girls get from the Easy Bake Oven.
Yeah, it just functions.
It's just nothing going on down there.
It just functions very differently.
But it's so sensitive that that direct stimulation
is almost irritating. Yeah.
It's sort of like a guy who's uncircumcised. His penis can be very sensitive.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep.
But it's so sensitive that the intercourse can be just enough
to get it.
To get it.
Yep. I think that's right.
Is that our theory?
Well, what we don't know is whether there's actually something going on inside also. Or that you constructed them. Because those also are girls that like the anal sex stuff.
Oh, yes. Wes?
How you doing?
You're 19?
Yep.
What's up?
My companion called up. And he was wondering, because for fun, I light my farts on fire.
Yeah.
He was wondering if it's doing anything dangerous to me or not. Because it feels like, when you first light them, it feels like it's coming back in.
Your companion called?
Yeah.
What's that mean?
That I'm a missionary for our church, the Mormon church.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So he was calling because I was just like my farts and fire, just kind of seeing what was
up. That's one of the prophets when they came through the. I saw where the prophet today. I was there where the prophets came through the canyon, and one of the first things they did when they arrived in the valley floor was lean back.
Well, that's how they propelled themselves. That's how they got the donkeys to climb the divide there. All right. I don't understand the part about your companion calling in, Drew. Do you understand that part?
They're teamed up.
I see.
We have to go two by two. It's kind of a weird thing. And
I see. Your companion, when you're out spreading the good news.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's crazy.
Lighting the farts.
Yeah.
I've lighted many a fart in my day.
Oh, yeah. You get some pretty awesome ones, eh?
Yeah. No difficulty.
Like atomic plumes.
I do, but I always do it in denim.
Yeah.
I would never do it in a pair of PJs or khakis or cargo pants.
I worry that people are going to light their clothing on fire.
I have a lot of ass hair, too, so it's a tinderbox between my legs. Thank God the ball sweat would put it out almost immediately.
But then the talc might explode.
The talc could go up. It's
an ecosystem.
It really is, and it's a neutrally assured destruction. I think it's what I got going on. I got the balls, I got the anus hair, and then I got the talc, and they're all this sort of standoff out there.
Right, right.
It's a lot like the Cold War.
Right.
All right, but yeah, I lied to them. Hey, people don't believe it.
Oh, I've witnessed. I'm bearing witness.
True.
I've seen the light.
Good stuff, right?
Yeah, you haven't done it in a long time. It's very disappointing.
I got to start wearing more denim.
It's been like a year.
I'm telling you, I'm off my gas game, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yeah. It's tough.
Yeah, sorry.
Christy?
Yes.
You're 25?
Okay.
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
Christy's a bitch.
Huh.
Christy's so angry. How angry is Christy?
Incredible.
I have no idea what her question is. I can tell you she's angry.
Yeah. You just feel you're
recoiling. I hate it. I wanted to whack her.
Obsessed with anal sex.
All right. Let me just talk to Christy. Christy, what happened to you?
Nothing.
Who did what to you? Where's your dad?
My boyfriend's able to give me...
I don't care about that. Where's your dad?
With my dad at home.
Yeah. Do you love him?
Yeah.
Oops.
What's the matter? Why don't you love him?
He beat on you when you were younger or something?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there we go.
There you go. What a shocking revelation.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
They say that most people grow up in dysfunctional homes.
Yeah, but we felt your dysfunction across the phone line.
And about
when you opened your mouth.
You said, I spoke to you for about a second and a half and felt your anger. So you're angry at men?
Angry at men, no.
But you're angry.
Authority.
You're angry at your dad, and that's angry at men.
Oh, no, I'm more angry at my ex-husband, actually. But
who has replaced dad?
What'd he do?
Surrogate dad.
Oh, he was an alcoholic. He's a good dad, I just not a good husband.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He's a good alcoholic dad?
No, actually, he quit drinking, so.
That's good. Now, what'd your dad do to you? Physical abuse?
More mental.
Mental? What kind of mental abuse?
Well, I haven't lived with my mom since I was 13. I've just pretty much listened to my dad, and he was a pretty big drug addict, so it was starting to smoke.
And another shocking revelation. Magically, she married an alcoholic. Magically.
Yeah. All right.
Magic.
Well, all right, baby.
I was 19.
All right, you've gotten some therapy since?
Al-Anon?
I've been in psychotherapy for 3 years.
Great.
Good. Tell them to work.
I'm on mood stabilizers. And
good. Tell them you got to work on your anger problem.
My anger problem? No, I'm a waitress, so I don't have an anger problem.
Believe me, you're angry.
Let me ask, watch this question. Do you feel like other people are often angry with you?
Sometimes.
Yeah, because she puts the anger into everybody else. We're the ones that experience it.
I don't really talk to too many people, so.
You're a waitress.
We get to experience all that because she puts it out there in the world.
All right. Well, anyway, Christy.
I'm not an angry person.
Yeah, you are. Yes, you are.
Well, we're feeling it for you.
Well, yeah. Either...
Well, I'm not a violent angry person.
No, I'll give you that.
That's true. That's good. All right.
I'm not a violent angry person.
So the only...
manically happy angry person.
All right. Settle down. I'm getting angry again. the only orgasm you have been anally. Yes?
Well, no, I have had regular orgasms, but I haven't had them until this year. But my boyfriend's really large, and it seems like when he goes in anally, he can hit my G-spot better.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to know if that's odd or different or weird.
That's
or...
different, but it's not weird per se. And it's really, again, not the G-spot. It's just sort of some stimulation that you get that works for you.
So you have an orgasm that way?
Yeah, like really intense ones.
How big is his dork?
8.5 by 4.
By 4.
A little counterintuitive that you'd start. You go, this is too big. Put it back here.
Yeah.
I never choke either, though, so it's
yeah.
Okay.
Never choke. Okay. All right, well, good times.
Never what?
I think she said I never choke either. I bet she would choke if she did that after the anal. Drew would, too.
Nay-nay.
Yetche. I know, it's a weird thing. It's like going, we got a ton of luggage to take on this trip. Let's take the two-seater. Like, so, big penis right in the ass. Bad times. 4 inches around.
What's
How did
that,
she measure that?
What's that, this?
It's kind of tough. It's actually not...
Not that big, huh?
Well, Christy?
Yeah?
Did you measure the circumference of his penis?
Yeah.
4 inches?
Uh-huh.
Use a cloth tape?
Yeah.
All right. You just went around it.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. And the length, you use the same thing?
I used one of those, but then I used the regular ruler, too.
Oh, really?
That she stabbed into his abdomen.
Yeah, he buried it in him like he was performing Harry Carey on himself.
No, I'm not that angry of a person.
No. He was just trying to get that.
We'll take ourselves a little bit of a break. We'll come back. When we come back, we're going to talk to Carrie. She's a female. She's recognizing suicidal symptoms in her friend.
No? All right, here we go.
Friend. We'll talk
here,
to her,
here,
too.
Here.
Alan? And what would happen if a man took a woman's birth control pill? There you go. After this. Buddy, Loveline, I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. All righty. Let's get to them phones. What do you say there, Drew?
Yeah.
Alan?
Yes, sir.
You're 21?
Yes.
What is up?
Hey, you are a funny, funny man, and Dr. Drew, you are a brilliant, brilliant man.
Thank you.
Before your question, I wanted to mention two things to you. You keep going about the government. Why didn't they do something about people who can't take responsibility for themselves? Especially like getting pregnant all the time.
Yeah.
They used to. There were laws, the last one, Vermont, ended it, I think, about 1973, where they would forcibly sterilize the feeble-minded, called it.
Yeah. You know what I found also interesting?
No problem with that.
Is that the woman that founded Planned Parenthood did so because she felt the wrong people were having children.
Nice.
Those were her words. It's like, wow.
I don't know. I know that makes you cross between Stalin and Hitler. Stitler, but I got a new porn title. But really, does it just people that can't take care of themselves can't take care of their children?
It's realistic.
Basically,
right?
People who are having difficulty taking care of themselves,
right.
Getting a second self to
would
take
would
care
be the
of.
Wrong person, more than a second self.
Well, it's as if someone had one horse and was having difficulty feeding it and cleaning it and shoeing it and exercising it, and then wanted to get 3 or 4 other horses.
Right.
Somebody would step in and say, "No, you can't do this."
Yeah, it's bad for the animals.
That's right.
Yeah. I also wanted to tell you I have some good news. There is a charity out there that I think their website is Cash for Contraception, where they pay drug addicted women $200 to get sterilized.
Oh yeah. We actually had the woman up here one time. Remember that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
She was a black woman from the Bay Area or north?
From Santa Ana, as I recall.
Mm-hmm.
Same place.
Yeah, same thing.
All right.
Anyway, my question was, I was curious, what would happen if a man were to take sort of like a woman's birth control pills or like the morning after pill or the abortion pill?
Get moody.
A single dose?
Spotting.
Single dose, you'd have some irritability and you'd feel funny, you'd get nauseated, but it would not really do anything to you. If you kept taking them, that's a pretty heavy estrogen exposure. You get breast development and tendons and sort of stuff. Yeah.
I have to try that. David?
Yes, sir.
You're 15?
Yes, sir.
What's up?
I was like, want to know, like, me and my girlfriend, we've been going out for like 6 weeks now, and like, I mean, I give her, like, we give each other Earl and everything.
Earl?
Yeah.
Texas tea?
Yeah, no, she's 14.
Black Earl.
Texas tea?
What, sir?
Okay, so you guys have been going out for how long?
6 weeks.
6 weeks.
Well, we knew each other for like 2 years.
And you give her
Earl.
Oral, yes, sir.
Oh, oral. Okay.
Yeah. I mean, and like, what I was wanting to know was, like, if I were to, you know, like, do that and, like, finger her, like, could she lose her virginity?
Well, what does virginity mean to you or to her?
Would I, like pop her cherry or...
Yes, you could do that. You could change the shape of her vagina, basically, but...
Really?
But you can, but be that as it may, though...
What, you change the shape of her vagina?
I mean, you can rupture hymen and stuff, yeah.
Rupture the hymen? And do you give the Earl with the finger banging?
Yes.
That's a tough move. I've actually pulled that one off the table.
You don't like that one?
I just don't have to do it anymore. I'm at that age. You know what I mean? There's a couple of things I've stopped doing. I no longer wash my own car because you can pay someone $7 and you can just sit there and read a People magazine and have them do it. It's not worth the $7. You know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
And the finger bang with the oral. It's no longer my sexual repertoire.
And again, let's think.
You
back.
Got that still? Is but that still
no,
on the table
no,
for
no,
you, Drew?
Well,
because I pulled it off.
Well, let's just think for a second in terms of the thing we were talking about earlier. The women that like something inside are not the ones that like the direct oral stimulation.
A lot of women like something inside and the tongue on the clitoris.
But it's not that big a deal. It's not something that...
No, and plus, if you got a big wingspan like I do, it's tough getting that hand up in there.
Oh, yeah.
I can barely eat.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's difficult. Mm. I'm just tucking my arm, my elbows, you know, putting it in my nuts. I'm trying to do the finger and do the tongue. All right, so David,
a huge night of reveals here tonight.
Yeah, you're fine.
So she could lose her virginity.
Well, look, virginity is a penis in the vagina.
Her virginity.
That's what virginity. Look,
he has her hymen mixed up with her virginity.
Yes, he does.
She could lose her hymen to a seagull if she fell asleep on the beach,
or if she fell off a horse or something. But be that as it may, I still have a problem. I still have a confusion about virginity when oral sex is and very intimate contact is not, still virginal.
Right. Okay. So
I mean, I'm just scared that like she would just lose her virginity and.
Yeah, that's not. No, she would not lose her virginity with your finger unless it had a head and balls on it.
Okay.
All right.
All right. Thank you.
All right, genius. But don't get her pregnant.
I won't.
All right. All right. We haven't really dissected that virginity thing in a little while.
I know.
Carrie.
Each other oral and everything.
Hi.
You're 21?
Yes, I'm 21.
What's going on?
Well, I got hung up twice when I called because I started out saying my friend, but it's kind of about me and a friend of mine. A couple years ago, I was suicidal, and I overcame it, and I was kind of hoping Linkin Park would still be there because they're the reason, and it sounds so stupid, but they're the reason why I overcame it, their music itself. But a friend
really?
Of mine, yeah.
Wow, it's funny because they don't. I mean, they're a great band, but they don't strike me as sort of motivational.
You'd be surprised. Have you ever listened to their CD Hybrid?
No, I don't listen to that crap. Come on,
well,
get serious.
Yeah. But no, seriously though, I about.
What am I 14?
Do what?
No, I'm hip. I'm hip.
Keep going.
Well, 2 years ago I was suicidal,
all right.
And friends tried to keep me, keep me happy. Family did, but a lot of people didn't really realize how serious it was.
Right.
And I just discovered Linkin Park a year before that.
All right. What is?
Did.
Yeah, they're not on tonight.
Yeah,
though, remember?
So they're not here.
I know.
All right.
But
just do it. All right. And listen, I like new music, but I just think of Blood, Sweat, and Tears as a newer band. I mean, that's me.
Well, that's okay.
Okay.
But anyway,
it's new music compared to like Baroque. All right, baby doll. So what's up? You haven't killed yourself,
up, dude.
Yeah.
The point being is I have a friend that's going through what I went through.
Then get her some help because
you know what? And I've tried.
Well, this is a life-threatening.
I've done so much.
This is a life-threatening condition.
Yeah, and I mean I've been there and I've done that.
And every time she threatens, you call the police.
How about you get her?
I've been there though, like wildly. She's threatening. She's just told me that she.
How about you get her Linkin Park CD?
She has it, thank you. And I don't appreciate the smart aleck comment.
And the what?
The smart aleck comment. That's just. I mean, it's. I'm serious.
I don't care.
What was?
Carrie's a coos. I was going to use the other word. Carrie's got to be hot. Carrie.
Yes.
You're good looking. Or you're absolute mess. Which is it?
I'm pretty good looking.
All right.
I mean, I'm. Now,
listen, why don't you drop the attitude, honey?
I'm not. I'm just trying to get some advice here.
All right.
All right. So here's the advice. You take every threat absolutely seriously. She needs to be on a hold. If she will not go for treatment with a life-threatening condition, that she's not allowed to make that choice, she goes. Mm-hmm. That's it. You have to tell her parents. You have to tell the authorities. You have to tell school. Whatever you have to tell to save her life, you have to do it. This is like, I'm not there, so I can't. No, it doesn't matter. You go do it.
This is hot chick talk. Jesus Christ. By the way, she does a 22-minute diatribe about how Linkin Park saved her life when she was suicidal. I dare to make the comment that she should get her suicidal friend the Linkin Park CD, and it's like, hey, buddy.
Cut the crap.
We don't got time to waste here.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
Really? All right. Amy?
Yes, hi.
You're 23. Great. What's going on?
Yeah, basically, first of all, thanks for taking my call, guys.
Making that call.
Ooh, Amy's making setting a new trend here. She she thought to herself, now, if I say something, if I even come off slightly smart-ass, he'll hang up on me. So I'm going to start up with Adam, thank you.
I'm not going to say anything like that.
No, but you open with, Adam, thank you for talking to me. That's good.
I said thanks for calling.
I listen to your show a lot, and I value what you guys have to say. Okay, I am 23 years old, and I'm slightly overweight. I wouldn't say I'm obese. I'm top heavy.
Ooh.
Which a lot of guys like. But I've it's basically like I'm shaped like a funnel. I have really small legs, but like after that I just get bigger. Which some guys I guess like. But anyways, I'm like 150 pounds.
Hold on. 150?
Yeah.
How tall are you?
I'm 5'4".
5'4".
So
hold on, I gotta do the radio math. 150, 5'4". What's 6 times 12, Drew?
72.
72. 72. Okay. Oops. Let's see. What line is she on, Drew? Line 2. Okay. I got 5'1 and 15 sixteenths and 163.
Okay.
All right. So let's move forward.
Let's move forward. So are you saying, is that overweight for my height?
Well, yeah.
Yeah, I
could
mean...
be 5'1 and 15 sixteenths, almost 5'2 and 163 pounds is a little bit overweight.
Right.
But if you're top heavy, I guess we could look the other way.
Right, but that's not it. I mean, like, I just don't have what society calls a perfect body, which
right.
A lot of people don't. But anyways...
What's your cup size?
My cup size is a D.
D?
A 36D. I've
nice.
Got a really broad back.
Uh-huh.
You know, I'm not thin.
Mm-hmm. No.
But basically, I'm super self-conscious. I've been this way ever since I was, like, 13 or whatever.
Well, let me look. There's certain concessions you have to make. Do you like black guys?
No. But listen to my point. My point is this. Mm-hmm. I think it basically has to do with orgasms. I think that, like, I just recently... have learned to give myself orgasms.
Right.
I just never masturbated.
Right, right.
I don't really know why. I think there's like some kind of feeling of guilt there.
Interesting.
And I just recently have been able to get myself off, but I've never really gotten off with a guy, and I think it's because I'm so self-conscious that I'm...
Have you had a boyfriend?
Yes, oh, tons. I've always had boyfriends.
Always had boyfriends.
Do you have one now?
No.
Maybe you need to find the one you're really into.
Well, maybe.
No, I was with the guy for 2 years. I was totally in love with.
Well, she doesn't believe that they would be into her.
Right.
And that's different than her being into them.
No, I understand. She has to expose some of these concerns to a guy that she feels comfortable with and really sort of work this out.
This sounds like
I would never, like, whenever I would fool around or have sex, I'd have to have the lights completely
dark. All right, so you have some body image issues.
Yes.
Okay.
And I think that's why I can't get off. I just recently kind of figured it out that's maybe why I've never really gotten off with a guy.
That makes sense. That's fine. That makes sense. You can't relax.
How can I overcome that?
Well, but that's not about losing weight. It's not about changing your body or looking at yourself differently. It's generally about relaxing. I mean, I think you're sort of an excited, uptight person.
But it's also expressing those anxieties to somebody you trust and being reassured by him.
Yeah.
In other words, if she has a guy she's getting involved with and says, look, I got to talk to you about how I feel. And he'll say, oh, you're great. You're, you know, just ease her into it.
I don't know if she's going to accept that, though.
Well, but eventually the people do.
Amy, you need a guy who's a mess.
No, I don't want a messed up guy. I'm a normal chick. I have lots of confidence in myself. I don't want a guy who's
But are you one of these people that goes, let's just say, Drew, stop eating so much. Jesus Christ.
What?
Go ahead.
All right, Drew. Are you one of these people that goes out with guys that are a little better looking than you are? You know what I'm saying?
No, not in particular. Like, I've dated really hot guys, and then I've dated guys that are just average, that just have awesome personalities.
Do you feel more comfortable when you're being intimate with the guys that are more average looking than the guys that are hot?
Yeah, a bit. Yeah.
Because I feel like you feel like your self-image is not all that great, and you want to go out with this, you know, hunky, handsome guy, but if you do that, then you got to keep the lights off because he looks better naked than you do.
No, well, my ex-boyfriend wasn't like a hunky guy. He was like this skinny guy. He wasn't like super attractive. He was your average guy.
And you were still kind of freaked out to be naked with him.
It basically doesn't matter what the guy looks like.
All right. Well, you got to get a little therapy then.
I think you just need to get a guy.
I don't even wear a sleeveless shirt out in public. Like, I just don't.
And I think you got to find a guy that really is into you and let him reassure how he sees you, and so you'll change how you see yourself.
Does that ever really help anybody?
She doesn't have an eating disorder, per se.
I know, but just bombard them with false praise.
But he may not be. He may really be into it.
Do you think she's going to listen to that?
Yes.
I would? I do.
I'll tell you why. She had an interesting opening, which was, I don't fit with what society's image of good looking is, which means in her head, it's like, I'm not so bad, but I'm made to feel uncomfortable.
Yeah, I think that's just her rap that she's developed over the years. All right, real fast. Jay?
Adam, what's up, baby?
What's happening? Jay, you want to know what the proper... Yeah, you want to know what the proper clothes to wear to a strip club are?
Yeah, I'm going to OG this weekend for a bachelor party.
All right, you're going to Vegas. I've done some serious thinking on this recently.
Recently? Why recently?
Somebody brought it up recently, and I thought, haven't we talked about this?
We have several times. I didn't realize that it was something you were preoccupied about, though.
Okay. Here's how you figure out what to wear, what pants you want to wear to a strip club. You look. Drew, you really learned a lesson with the eating thing, didn't you?
I'm listening to you. If I jumped into the middle of your little diatribe, you would freak out.
Oh, you ruined everything. Drew, I'm hearing you chomping in the background.
No, you're not. Are you?
Yeah.
Okay, well, I'm sorry.
Look at Anderson with the puzzle.
I'm eating rice. How is that chomp?
You're eating vegetables. Please. 10 seconds ago, I told you to put the beef bowl down. That's right. Game on. Okay, look. Let me say this. And we're moving on. We're breaking clean from this taco stand after this. You want to look in your closet, and you want to pick out the pair of pants that you would least like to be wearing if you got in a moped accident.
Least like to be wearing.
Least.
What if it's a guy that has easy release, quick release?
I don't care. You wear the pair of pants that you would least like to be in if you got into a moped accident. And conversely, if you want to know the best pair of pants to wear mopeding, you wear the pants you would least like to be wearing
at
a strip club. Something with, like, you know, a stud stapled into it and reinforced leather crotch and knees and ass, that kind of stuff. Basically, Evel Knievel's jumpsuit. All right, we'll take a quick break. Drew's ironically going to stop eating. Now he's finished. Right. Now that the mic's called,
of course,
he's done eating. Hey, everybody. Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. Let's go. Drew's polished off his veggies. He's ready to rock.
That's right.
Chris?
Hi.
You're 20?
Yeah.
What's up?
Well, my boyfriend and I were messing around the other night, mm-hmm. and I looked at the tip of his penis, and I realized that he has two holes.
You? Mm-hmm. How about that?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah. So there.
Yeah, that freak you out?
No, it didn't. I was just like, your penis has two holes on it. And he goes, everybody's penis has two holes on it.
Interesting.
Nice angle.
Yeah.
I hope he doesn't really believe that.
Yeah, and then she's like, my last boyfriend only had one. Freak! You dated a freak! What'd you meet him, in the circus?
Did you have one eye, too?
Yeah, one ear, one nostril. Wow. Okay, so...
He didn't really believe that, does he?
No, he told me, he goes, well, here's the deal. I was circumcised too far down, and I was like, no, my mom's a doctor, and I've watched circumcisions, and they don't cut that part of the penis.
No, it's called a phimosis. It's a pretty common congenital defect, and they can be repaired pretty easily.
Oh, what was that? Was that during Bring Your Daughter to Work Day, where you got to watch them lop off the prepubes of the young kids? Or?
Pretty much.
Really? That's it's all right with everybody, huh?
The hell were you when you had to witness all that?
How old was I?
Just planning to when I should bring my kids along for the colonoscopies and things.
Yeah. How old were you?
Like 15.
15, yeah.
Isn't that weird? Is that weird?
No. Not a doctor's family.
Not weird to see the 15-year-old girl watch the kid screaming bloody murder, the blood pouring out of his genitalia?
He didn't really scream that much.
Yeah, they don't...
Tough Jew.
Doesn't bother.
It's a scrappy Jew. All right. One of the good ones.
So, Chris, if he has any functional problems, they should repair it and, you know, just leave it be.
The hole is where, exactly?
Well, it's just right underneath. It's like instead of being one hole, it's two.
All right. Well,
It's like that.
Yeah, I mean, instead of one hole, it's two. That just means there's a little land bridge between the...
No. It's like down under the head.
Well, that's not what she said, though.
No, it's not down under the head.
Oh, not? Okay.
Drew.
Is it on the head still?
Yeah, it's on the head of the penis. Right. It's like where there's usually one hole, there's two.
Well, that may just be a septated urethra.
Yeah,
that's a little
what I was
different.
Thinking.
That's a little different. And that's even less of a deal.
Has anything come out of it yet while you were there?
I don't know. Yeah, maybe.
Yeah. So does it...
Jack in the Box?
Does it come out like a pickle fork? Like, I mean...
I've never taken, like, a microscope to it, but it probably does.
Well, I mean, I'm wondering, Drew, I'm just kind of doing the math. Maybe you could sort of hide in the space between the...
Who could?
One could.
Uh-huh.
I'm just saying it could either be horrible thing for a woman or maybe a good thing.
I see.
If you could find its path. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it could go past your ears, what you're saying.
That's right.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. All right, he's all right then, Chris.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
All righty. Wow. Mom's a doctor. That's weird. What about the parents of the kid who's getting the circumcision? That's all right?
It's good times.
Just hang out?
Yeah.
Bring the kids? Want to take a camera? Have like a...
No, no? Documenting would be a little different.
All right. Alicia?
Yeah.
You're 16?
Yeah.
What's up?
Nothing.
All right. What's your question?
I was wondering if he can get pregnant by pre-cum.
If he can?
No, me.
No, if you can, you can.
Absolutely.
Okay.
And you guys aren't practicing... Contraception, huh?
What?
What are you doing to prevent pregnancy?
Sometimes we, use condoms and sometimes we don't.
All right, well, the sometimes you don't makes the sometimes you do sort of superfluous.
I know. But, he'll pull out before he comes.
Yeah, but that doesn't matter.
Drew, you think someone who's using the pull-out technique knows what superfluous means?
You're right. Have to use a condom 100% of the time, all the time.
Okay.
And there is secretions that come out of the penis before ejaculation that has a lot of sperm in it.
Oh, okay.
And that gets you pregnant.
Oh, man.
Oh, baby.
Yeah, good times.
Yeah. You got to get on some birth control.
Yeah.
Okay.
You use those condoms religiously.
You do that, right?
Yeah.
All right.
All right, thanks. Right.
Yeah.
What is that doctor thing where it's like, well, if you use condoms half the time... It's not like you. It's like not using condoms at all.
It's. I don't understand the statistics, but it's like the same thing with seatbelts. If you don't wear your seatbelt 100% of the time, the effectiveness of wearing a seatbelt at all drops dramatically off.
Would you rather your kid never wear a seatbelt or wear it
half the time?
All right, then. Touche. Keith? I mean, Heath?
Hey, Adam.
What's up, Heath?
You're a huge fan, Adam. I love you. You are God, Adam.
Thank you.
I just wanted to know if your Botox worked on your forehead, stopped the sweating.
No. Doesn't he sound like he's speaking through one of those voice boxes, but not one.
Bit.
Not because it's like one that converts your voice to geek. Like, do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's not electronic sounding.
I'm on a cell phone.
All right. Listen, buddy. Here's what happened. My forehead sweats profusely, and I'm tired of it. And Dr. Bruce said, they say you give a Botox injection to your forehead, it stops the sweating. I said, well, count me in. So he shows up here one day with his Botox syringe, and he says, yeah, we'll do a little test pattern. And I said, all right, how many? We'll do about 28 shots across your forehead, and we'll see if it works. If it works, we'll then complete the job with the 3,000 other shots in your forehead. I said, Bruce, this could have been something you could have brought up when you were talking about it originally. He goes, well, let me just do it. So I sat here in excruciating pain while he injected this Botox into my forehead.
Man, you pussy, you turned white and almost fainted and scared the poor guy.
Oh, please. Times, like, really, literally 18 shots in the forehead, all painful. And you know what it's done, Drew?
Nothing.
Zero.
Yeah.
Now I sweat more because I have a post-traumatic stress disorder from the Botox injections. Fantastic. Hey, everybody. It's Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number, 1-800-LOVE-191. Hey, Anderson. Go dig up some blood, sweat, and tears. Come on now.
Yeah, we need a little upbeat.
Thursday night, you know what I'm saying? We got
no upbeat
guests.
Yeah.
Can we get some other than blood, sweat,
no,
and tears?
No, we want blood, sweat,
and hear
tears.
Some blood, sweat, and tears.
I want to hear that.
Brian will go find it.
What's your name again?
Lucretia McEvil.
No Lou Christie.
Lou Christie. Drew didn't know who Lou Christie was.
There's actually no Lou Christie back there at all. Shocking.
Jacqueline?
Yes.
You're 19?
Yes.
What's up?
Okay, I was, halfway diagnosed with genital herpes, or not genital herpes, genital warts. I know that sounds really dumb, but, during the examination, they said that that's the only thing that they could think it was, but when, on my pap, I came out negative for it.
That's interesting. So you have a possible herpes, or possible warts.
Right. And
well, what does that mean? When they diagnosed it, they thought that's what you have, but then they check it and you didn't have it?
Well, it didn't show up on my pap, when in the visual in the visual exam, that's the only thing that the doctor could name them.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
Okay.
And I was just wondering how long, if someone I was, sleeping with caught them, how long would it take for them to show up?
To actually see warts?
Yeah.
You may never see them.
Really?
Yeah, guys don't have to have the war, but they can carry the virus.
What? So, you have a boyfriend right now?
No.
Girlfriend?
No.
Okay. So what should she do? I'd look at it as not having them.
No, look at it having them and take the appropriate precautions and realize that he, if you indeed have them, has them. Even though you don't see the warts, he's got it.
Okay. So is that common that they don't show up on the test?
No, that's kind of weird. You need to be retested and maybe some more sophisticated testing.
I would
done.
Just assume I didn't have them. I mean, that's me. I think the vagina is half full. Drew thinks it's half empty.
I think it's half full of warts. You think it's half empty of warts?
Half empty of warts.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, look. Get it retested.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Definitely.
Why wouldn't the doctor retest it?
I think he probably would still have to come back in 4 months and redo it.
He would? Yeah. Why not just do it then? It wouldn't not producing virus? It wouldn't show then?
Yeah.
Okay. Billy? Shut up! He did the super chicken opening.
Yeah. I think that was actually the tape of it, wasn't it? Sounded like it.
I don't know. It sounded pretty good.
I have the Terminator, too. You want it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Terminated.
All right.
I'll be back. Hasta la vista.
Yeah, that's great. Anderson, you got some competition in the nerd department, buddy. All right.
That's it.
Such a full moon.
Billy's done.
All right, Billy.
That's so true, Anderson. It is a full moon.
There was a lunar eclipse tonight, right?
Yep.
What goes on with that lunar eclipse?
What, the Earth gets in the way of the sun shining on the moon.
The Earth gets in the way of the sun shining on the moon.
That's why we see the moon, because the sun lights it up.
Yeah, from like behind us or
yeah,
something.
Yeah.
And now, because it's daylight wherever the sun thing is, and we're on the dark side of the Earth,
yeah.
but we see the moon lit up.
Yeah.
And then, so we have a crescent moon that's the Earth's shadow in the way
yeah,
of the moon.
Yeah, yeah.
And now what happened tonight?
We moved in front of the moon.
So now the moon's dark?
Yeah.
So what? Half the time you look up, you don't see anything, right?
Yeah.
So. I mean, you look up in the sky at 2 in the morning, you don't see the moon, do you?
No.
When do you see the moon? You see the moon from when it comes out to about 11 or 12
I
or something?
Know. I don't know.
Let's go find that moon. Do we have blood, sweat, and tears? Yeah? Put Lucretia McEvil on. Come on. That's my song.
Jeremy? Oh.
Yeah.
I'm feeling better already.
Aren't you?
Yeah.
Yeah. True had the hernia surgery. He's feeling better. Yeah. Yeah, it's rock and roll, kids. Sky, this is back when bands sung about hard living, hard loving women who were trouble.
And bewitched.
That's right. And they likened them to devils. Yeah. Shaking, home breaking. Yeah,
turn that up a little bit.
This is a woman. And let me tell you, these ain't some pissed off kids from Bakersfield with a couple of tats on their neck. These are musicians, everybody.
Isn't this where the producer is supposed to do like the cutthroat thing and say no more?
Yeah. Her mom was the talk of the sticks. Yeah, she had trouble parents. You see Lucretia did? Both her parents were trouble. She never did anything worthwhile.
Before
love
life.
She shakes her ass. She breaks up relationships.
Yeah, it's borderline.
Yeah. Uh-oh, the devil. The devil is controlling Lucretia McEvil. You gotta figure with a last name like McEvil, she's in with Lucifer, though, you know?
Isn't it weird that we're just beginning to come to the understanding of
what?
The people that we think are possessed just had a little bit of a character flaw.
Yeah.
They're bad parents.
All right, hold on. A little Christian there. What you gonna do? Woo! Or maybe you can. Been on hold for 80 minutes. All right.
Oh, he's sleeping.
Is he snoring?
Yeah, listen.
Turn
it down
for a second.
Turn him up. There he is. Is that snoring or is that...
Sounds like a space shuttle.
That's the strangest
snoring. That's snoring. That's bizarre snoring.
Yeah. It really, it's like the space shuttle trying to steer itself. What is that?
What is that? Is he awake?
Jeremy.
Now,
that's snoring.
It's in the cadence of a snore.
Yeah.
Right? Let's try to breathe along.
It really, it's afterburners.
Yeah, it should come out faster. All right, hold on a second. I've said it once, I've said it a thousand times.
There you go. Thank you. Good.
No greater compliment could be paid to the host of a radio show than to have one out of three of the people listening asleep when he gets to them.
Not people listening, people calling in, the ones that are excited.
Yeah.
The ones
yeah.
that are nervous.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a good time.
All right, let's listen to a little trumpet solo here.
Get Charlene on while you're listening.
Blow, Daddy.
Charlene.
Yeah. Okay. I had a threesome twice with my boyfriend, and now he's asking for more.
Yeah.
Well, you know.
So is he, like, losing interest, or is he just trying to take advantage of what...
You've opened Pandora's box. Guys are...
He's gaining interest in threesomes.
When guys find something they like, they aren't apt to...
Go back to the well.
Break away, yeah.
Listen to that horn.
Well, like, I'm used to it, and I like it, and it's fun, but I just don't want it, like, every single day. Not, like, I mean, once a month would be fine.
Yeah.
Every day.
Have you told him that?
Yeah, but he doesn't think he's asking that often.
Well, who's the girl you're having it with?
One of them was my waxer, and the other one was a friend of his.
Your waxer?
Yeah.
You're having it with a 42-year-old Vietnamese woman?
No, she was, like, 24, and she was, like... She seemed like she had, like, a good background. Like, she was clean, and she was nice, and she's basically, like, seen my, pussy before, so.
Uh-huh. I see. Let me ask what goes on when you get that waxing.
She just waxes, like, inside the lips and, like, the ass and everywhere, so.
And are you completely naked?
Yeah, well, bottom half, yeah.
Okay, so it's, you don't have to strip down your bra or anything humiliating like that. You just spread eagle on the stirrups there.
And they, rip that stuff out?
I understand that women have to get waxed or want to get waxed
down
there. I mean,
what would happen if you tried to wax your ass, Adam? Oh, my God. It would just tear off.
There's not enough wax.
No.
They'd have to mine wax from different planets.
But let's say they did. They just pull your ass off.
My ass would come off. No, it's like once in a while. No, like when you buy a tomato and you try to pull that ripe sticker off and the skin comes off on it.
That'd be your ass.
That'd be my ass. Now, let me say this real fast. How big a tragedy was it when we didn't have a goddamn sticker on every goddamn piece of produce we buy?
Yeah.
I'm sitting there with my fingernail trying to fidget the sticker off the tomato, and then eventually the skin just breaks off, and I have a skin hole in the tomato, and I think, really, a sticker on every tomato? This is what we need? Every single one of them? You couldn't just put it on the package of six on the outside? I got to take a razor blade to my banana? Sounds painful.
It does.
All right, where is she?
You got rid of her.
I didn't get rid of her.
She dropped off, looks like.
Oh, that bitch.
Well, what was the question?
She was having threesomes.
The boyfriend, should she continue to let him engage in threesomes or cut him off now before he gets too into it?
Yeah.
Well, the relationship's not going to survive anyway.
No.
She should do whatever she enjoys because this is done for.
Are you saying to me, though, when you go to a waxer as a female, you're completely naked from the bottom down and your legs are akimbo?
Tara?
You're just knees spread out and they're just combing through your crack. I mean,
That's a great Blood, Sweat, and Tears song.
Combing through your crack, babe. Well, you know, yeah. No, play Combing Through Your Crack, Anderson. Anderson, play Go Down Gambling. That's my next one, yeah.
Tara, is that what happens?
Yeah, that's what happens. Okay. Here's what I thought. I thought you put on like a thong back bikini or something.
Or a towel or something that they would expose certain parts.
Yeah, yeah, like, well, no, I thought you put like a bikini on and you sort of cinch it in and they use that as sort of their template. Like, there's their line. Like, here's what you're going to be wearing. Holy Christ. Dumping wax down there. Okay.
Tara said she doesn't know. She goes full 70s.
Full 70s. Let's hear Go Down Gambling. Yeah. Yeah.
It's Jeremy?
It works with the theme.
We're going to just see.
Jeremy's still sleeping.
There. It's that same crazy sound.
I can't get past that because it sounds electronic.
Yes, it does have electronic sound.
But it starts off as an exhale, and then cuts abruptly.
Yeah, it's weird.
Maybe he's wearing a diving helmet or something.
Huh.
Okay.
Well, there we go. He's done for.
Okay, let's talk to Jose. Go Down Gambling, Anderson. Come on.
There we go.
Jose.
Hey, what's up, bud?
What's up? You're 18.
Yes, I am.
You into Blood, Sweat, and Tears at all?
Not really, dude. I'm more into like a Metallica Slayer deal.
Maybe one of our new themes ought to be to play stuff under Loveline.
Excuse me?
Yeah. Music going under Loveline.
Yeah, well,
see if it affects the tone of the show.
You like Metallica and Slayer, you like Blood, Sweat, and Tears.
And sometimes we'll
really?
Put, sometimes we'll put like classical music on for me.
Yeah.
That'd be good.
That's cool.
All right.
Respectable.
What's happening, Jose?
Nothing, dude. I was getting late today, earlier on.
No.
Yeah, you remember me last year, aren't you? Are you the one that offered me $2,000 for my kid, aren't you?
Oh, you have a kid?
Yeah, didn't you offer me $2,000?
It's now $2,800.
Oh, yeah, it was $2,800. That was around there, right?
All right, please. I'm more Go Down Gambling, Anderson. Go ahead, Jose, sorry.
No problem, dude. Earlier on, I was having sex with my girlfriend, and pretty much, we were getting it on nice and straight. It was pretty good. And then about like halfway through it, we switched, and I don't know, it started to hurt like an MF down there.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, bad, dude.
Mm-hmm.
The skin?
I don't know, man. It happened last year. We were
Jose?
Yeah?
The skin hurt?
Somewhere below the penis. I don't know, like somewhere down there. It's just really sucked. Yeah, I guess.
Inside hurt or the skin hurt?
The skin.
The skin.
How many times he got to ask you that, you retard?
The skin.
Hey, lay off, Adam. Come on.
All right. But he asked you three times.
All right.
The skin started burning.
Yeah, pretty much. Pretty bad.
Where
I'm
was
what that meant.
Where
was like, the, well, what's going on down there?
Where is the burning?
Right below the head, I guess. Yeah, right below the head.
The skin started burning. So not inside the shaft, but the skin itself started burning.
Yeah, pretty much.
Hold on. We got to rock out for a second.
Could you see it?
Bring it up.
Say it when you're running low.
Yeah, see, this song's about gambling. Go down gambling. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. Ooh. All right. Jose?
Jose, is there a rash there? Is there anything to see?
I checked it out, dude. Not really, no. Nothing.
All right, so maybe just sort of too much friction or something.
Whatever it was, that happened last year, too. And I don't know, I think one of my friends was talking to me about it once, and he told me the same thing happened to him. Like, you know, he was going at it with one of his girls, and the same thing happened.
How about a little lubrication?
I don't know, man.
Well, here's the deal. If a rash actually develops, make sure somebody looks at it, because that's how herpes gets going.
Really?
If it's just some sort of trauma to the area, then take it easy.
Your wife's 16?
Something like that. By the way, Drew.
Something like that.
My girlfriend's on the patch thing. How long before that thing? How long before I could actually have unprotected sex with her?
That's a good question. They're once a week. Usually, right. We have people go through a month cycle before you really are unprotected. So I imagine
it's the same. She's been going with the cycle for about a month and a half. You think it's safe?
Oh yeah, yeah.
She was fine. She was on depot.
She's safe.
No, right. It's fine. She's fine.
Oh. We got to rock out now a little bit more because it's really going to kick in here. Let's bring it up now. Never goes out of style, does it?
Like the freaking Rain Man.
Go down gambling. We got to get blood, sweat, and tears on this show, Drew.
I told you they're coming to the Cerritos concert hall.
We're
how about when the calls start to go south? I'll just turn it up.
Yeah, okay. That's a good idea. Susan.
Yes.
You're 39.
Yes, I am.
Go down gambling.
Yes.
Yeah. Well, I was calling to ask Dr. Drew. I've got degenerative arthritis in my jaw,
both
joints of my jaw.
Yeah.
They diagnosed it about 3 years ago. I basically don't have any
cartilage right.
left.
Yeah.
Bad times.
Yeah.
What's that mean?
Well, it's when you have to have knee replacements or anything like that. That's because there's no cartilage in between the cap and the bone of the knee.
It's a little more different than the jaw, but keep going.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, sometimes it locks up. I'll wake up in the morning and I can't open my mouth.
That's great.
Mm-hmm.
Wish my wife would get
that. I'm on a lot of different medications.
Can't open your mouth. Whoa. Can't open your mouth.
Yes.
Because our degenerative arthritis, it locks open.
Well, it'll
doesn't lock closed.
It'll
not unless you're having a muscular spasm of the temporalis muscle, which is a medication side effect.
Okay. Well, they do have me a muscle relaxant also because I'm really kind of a high-strung person.
Mm-hmm.
And so I used to have a lot of high-strung jobs where I was managers of restaurants and social, you know, things like that, and I was I'm so nervous. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Right. Crank up the blood, sweat, and tears. It's all right. That's our parachute now, this blood, sweat, and tears. Yeah. Just there. Call starts going south.
There's your part,
crank
Adam.
Crank up the blood.
The cowbell.
I play the cowbell. Yeah. Ride a painted pony, let the spinning wheel spin. It's going to be a new karaoke number for me.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Well, Susan, what's the question exactly?
Well, anyway, I'm just wondering, is there anything I can do? I've heard that there's basically not too much I can do. I'm just going to be in pain the rest of my life.
Yes, TMJ syndrome. TMJ syndrome is rather chronic, yes.
Yeah, they told me I could do surgery.
What's the question?
Well, I just want to know if they told me if I did surgery, it would be like 60% that it probably wouldn't work. 40%.
Would you mind a reflecting sun? Just let it shine within your mind and show you the colors that are real. Yeah. All right.
Basically, my question is there anything I can do to fix that so that I can have a normal life and I don't have to be on medications or pain?
That's not your question.
Pardon me?
You've consulted a million doctors about that.
I have.
Yeah. Okay, I'm not going to tell you anything different than what other people have told you.
I'm pretty much stuck for the rest of my life.
Riverside! All right, Susan, you're a little nutty or what?
I love it.
No, are you nutty?
Am I nutty or naughty?
Nutty.
I'm nutty and naughty.
All right, baby doll. Maybe that's... look, Drew, how come you knew she was nuts at the beginning?
We'll tell people what I did to you.
Well, Drew said she's nuts. He did the finger around the head thing. Drew, how did you know she was nuts?
Both the somatic preoccupations, the kinds of preoccupations, and the way she made me feel. All those things.
Keep going to my hand. All right. Fantastic. Where are we, Drew?
Here. Right here.
Don?
Yeah?
We got to take a break there, baby.
Did you play
Lucretia McEvil in your high school marching band?
She just said she loves the song.
No, it was college, and we also played spinning wheel, too.
Wow. What college did you go to?
University of Texas.
Wow.
Austin? Lesbian.
Oh. What?
I didn't say that.
Really? Yeah, what did you play?
Euphonium.
The flugelhorn.
The what?
Euphonium.
It's like a little tuba.
Like a handheld tuba.
Oh, that thing? That thing is only in marching bands, right? You don't see that anywhere else.
It's in concert bands and English orchestras and stuff like that.
What's it called?
Euphonium. It's also a baritone.
All right. And so what would be your part in Lucretia McEvil?
Boom, boom. Oh, that's it.
Yeah, like we get stuck with the bass line.
Yeah, I know.
Typically.
It's very disappointing. When I played the trumpet in the 7th grade, and we finally got to play some upbeat Neil Diamond song instead of Grand Old Flag. It's real exciting when you're in band class and you get to play a song that people know of. No, we're done with her.
No, your question.
That was her question.
No, she had a question.
She had a question?
Yeah, hey.
Yeah.
Hold on. We're going to go to commercials.
What was your question?
Okay.
Did you have a question?
Yeah, I do. I can't seem to say no to guys.
All right. Hold on a second. All right. That's a good question. Take a quick break. We'll be right back after this. Hey, everybody. It's Loveline. I'm Adam. That's Dr. Drew. Phone number 1-800-LOVE-191. We will hop back to the phones. Let's see. Next week, we got Deftones, Powerman 5000.
Oh, my God. Rosa Blasi.
Oh, old Rosa.
Strong Medicine.
All right. This is good times.
Oh, my God, we have a holiday.
We have a holiday?
Yeah, 25th.
What day is that?
Memorial Day.
We don't have to work then?
Best of.
Oh, good man, times. That is great.
That is good times.
You'll be hearing the Blood, Sweat, and Tears show on the Best of. I can tell you that right now. Don?
Hey, what's up?
Phone screener Brian said he may have found a soulmate in you.
Oh, I totally felt the same way about him.
Whoa.
Yeah, you play...
I was going to tell you he sounded totally awesome on the phone.
He's hot.
Yeah, he had a really good energy.
Yeah, he's got a nice vibe about him.
I think because you said it was easy. That's probably why.
No. It's just you play Lucretia McEvil.
On the flugelhorn.
On the flugelhorn, and you're into nonstop sex.
He's gay.
Yeah. Put a little Anderson. Put a little God Bless the Child.
What's that? Another Blood, Sweat, and Tears?
Well, yeah. Okay.
But it's not really that you're easy or you have sex all the time, but that you can't say no. Is that right?
Yeah, that's definitely part of it. But it's kind of like I have a drive of a guy and sort of the mindset of a guy. Like, I have no problem completely hooking up with guys and then never talking to them again.
All right. Well, there's two versions of that. Now, one version is that's you. That's just your biology, and that's the way you go.
Mm-hmm.
The other version, though, is a sexual compulsion built off some history of sexual abuse in childhood. Did something like that happen?
No. Like, my parents have been together, and I haven't experienced any.
So this is just you. Yeah, that's kind of what I was picking up. This is just you.
Yeah,
okay, well, there you go. Interestingly, not a lot of women can do this, and it doesn't fit their biology. They don't feel good about it, but some can, and are just fine with it. And there you go. Nothing wrong with that.
All right.
So it's okay?
Good times.
Be careful. Don't get pregnant and don't get a disease. Wear condoms.
What other songs did you play in the college band?
Oh, gosh. Like, all kinds of stuff. A lot of 70s, like 25 or 6 to 4.
We play a lot of Chicago.
We did Golden Earring, too.
Why? Did Radar Love?
Yeah.
That was one of my favorites.
Your big gal?
Yeah, and Crazy Train.
Crazy Train?
Yeah.
This is the University of Texas?
Yeah.
In Longhorn?
Yeah.
Wow. That's good times. Out on the field at the football game?
No, basketball games.
Didn't play the football games?
No,
you were like in the pep band.
Like two separate bands. Yeah.
I see, yeah. You had to be good to play in that one because there's only a few people in that one, right?
I suppose. I have an uncommon instrument, so it's pretty convenient.
So do I. It's uncommonly small.
Yeah. What,
your instrument, though.
Yeah. What are you, you a big gal?
Not really. I'm, like, muscular.
All right. There's haunchy woman to tote around that
instrument.
That
but interesting that she has sort of masculine body features, too.
Yeah.
It's interesting. You're a lesbian. No, no.
Mm-hmm.
New.
Let's bring it up a little.
You need a control in here.
All right, that's all right.
Right?
Mm-hmm. Won't be around
anymore. No, no. Heather.
What's up, Heather?
Nothing. What are you doing?
Just sitting here chilling, a little blood, sweat, and tears.
Talking about the Holocaust.
I want to say that you guys are awesome, and I love you.
Thank you.
Geez, I was just in Utah 3 hours ago.
Oh,
yeah,
really?
No, it's beautiful. Oh, my God.
It's pretty, but it's just boring. I live in Provo, so it's like...
A little ways away.
All right.
Happy Valley.
What's up?
My question is, lately I've been getting this... I smoke pot weed. I'm like a pothead. And in the past 2 weeks, I've been getting this weed from this guy, like 3 bags a week of an eighth, you know?
Yeah. All right, hold on. We got to rock out a little bit here. It's starting to pick up a little here.
Let's rock, Heather. Heather.
Yes?
Okay, so what's the problem? You smoke a lot of pot.
Yeah, and, lately, this stuff, we've been getting this week, it's different from what he had before, and it's, been giving me sharp pains in my stomach, and, I thought it was just me, but I asked my boyfriend, and he's like, yeah, I get those.
Causes abdominal cramps, so if they gave you some
pot. Wait, he's going to start screaming. He's going to start screaming here.
I have withdrawal.
Well, wait a minute, baby!
What'd you say about withdrawal?
Yeah.
What?
What'd you say about the withdrawal?
I said, I've been smoking it too much to have withdrawal.
No, but maybe there's such less THC in this pot that you're getting sort of a low-level withdrawal or something.
Yeah, it's kind of swaggy weed.
I wonder.
All right, little MA.
Yeah, you need to look into this, Heather. It's a pretty serious thing. You've got to get a sponsor. Got to start working 12 steps.
What are the incidents of addiction, let's say, after 5 years of marijuana smoking?
Well, it's not so much the incident. If you've been smoking daily for 5 years, you are addicted. The marijuana addiction occurs very, very rapidly. It's a biological predisposition of subset of alcoholism, probably. Not all alcoholics can get marijuana addiction. The subset get it. And those that do get it right away, and they will smoke for many, many years. So it's not so much the duration as whether or not this sort of switch gets thrown.
I see. Every child's got to have his own point. Well taken, bro. Well taken.
Let's go back to speaking in Indian gibberish, can we? That was my favorite part of the show so far.
All right. Let's hear, what did we hear, spinning wheel yet?
Yeah, we did. We got to go back to Lucretia McEvil.
All right. Jacob?
Yeah.
What's up?
I have a question. Every time I get high and I have sex, I don't know, it seems like I go 10 times longer.
When you get high. Well, with marijuana you're talking about?
Yeah.
Well, that's a central nervous system depressant. Almost any drug you use to get high is going to work against sexual functioning in some fashion. I mean, it's difficult to orgasm when you're on stimulants. It's difficult to have erections and be aroused on alcohol and things like marijuana. So, yeah, of course.
Yeah, because, I don't know, it seems like I can't get hard all the way either.
Right, that's what I'm saying.
This is just from Wayne?
Yeah, just
some people, yeah.
Nah, I don't like this song, Anderson. Let's go to the next
song.
It's a song I don't like.
Let's Bless Out in Tears again?
Yeah. We'll go to the next one. See what it is. All right. So what was his problem? His problem with the spit valve on his flugelhorn?
Pot makes him not get hard.
Nah, I don't like this one either. Yeah, keep...
There's only a few, then.
No, we're just going to keep
like three.
Going. That's all. We'll find it. Hey, Jacob?
Yeah.
So what's Drew, what's he need to do?
Not smoke so much pot.
All right, don't smoke so much pot.
Well, I don't really smoke a lot. It's just that, like I've smoked pot and then, I ended up having sex. I don't know. Just I go longer than when I don't smoke.
Then things won't work so well.
All right.
All right, buddy.
Thanks, guys.
Well, you want me to give you something else you take to correct the
bot? Lost it love before. Got mad and closed the door. It's karaoke night here. Oh, yeah. This song kicks in a little. You remember this one,
yeah.
right?
Oh, yeah. Sounds like Tom Jones.
Hey, Eddie.
Hi.
What's up? You in a blood, sweat, and tears? I'm trying to figure out the sort of demo of the audience. I mean, I know you're in a blood, sweat, and tears, but are you a Lucretia McEvil man, or are you a spinning wheel type of guy?
Spinning wheel.
Spinning okay. wheel. Okay.
Eddie, what's your question, Eddie?
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm 18, and recently my brother, who's 14, mm-hmm. asked if he could masturbate with me.
With you?
With me.
Wow. Yeah?
I told him no, of course.
Yeah, of course.
But I'm kind of concerned, like...
I would say that...
What does with you mean, exactly?
What?
What does that mean, with you?
I guess, like, both of us
Hold
together.
On, hold on. Here's what you tell him. You just gotta yell, thank you, baby! All right. All right. I just had to get that in.
Eddie,
has he ever been molested or anything?
Not that right,
we gotta crank it up now. I got that. I can see you, baby! Baby, I can hear you calling me! In here. Yeah. It gets going here. Drew, you remember this one, right?
Yeah, of course. And Eddie, hold on, please.
This came out, what were you, 38?
12. All right, Eddie.
Yeah.
I think those kinds of, that's such an out-of-line, sort of bizarre request. I think it warrants evaluation. Like you tell your parents or school or somebody that you think your little brother's in trouble.
All right.
I don't know. One time, I sort of, well, we share a room, and he was by my bed, and I think he was jerking off by me, and I just, like...
Ah, this is bogus.
Is it bogus?
You made me so, so very happy, baby! I'm so glad you came into my life. This is back when songs were like eight songs piled into one.
Yeah, yeah.
This is like song number four. And that was a bogus call.
I'm afraid it was.
Yeah, because you tell them what to do. Here's how you know it's a bogus call, by the way.
They keep going around.
You give the person the answer. You're like, hey, this guy needs psychiatric evaluation. He should talk to a therapist. And they go, yeah, because one time he was beating off in my hair.
Yeah.
And you go, yeah, I think you should discuss this with a counselor. He beat off in a bird's nest, and then he put it on his head.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? It's what good is a bogus call when you tell them to go talk to a counselor? It's like end of call. You got to keep going with the crazy stuff.
Sure.
All right. Laura?
Hey.
We got to take a break.
How's it going?
You digging blood, sweat, and tears?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm going to pick out a good one. I may go pick out another CD. Oh, yeah.
That'd be great.
All right. Hold on. It's a blood, sweat, and tears superset going on here tonight. You know, this is alternative radio.
Yeah,
I mean, look, alternative radio could play alternative music, but what's really alternative?
I think something nobody else plays.
That's right, playing something alternative to alternative.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
All right, hold on, Laura. I'm going to pick another CD. We'll be back. Well, normally my policy is not to talk when Drew's not in the studio when the show starts, but he had the hernia surgery, so I feel bad.
Well, now that I've got an emergency at home, I'm probably have to leave in a minute here.
What do you got going?
Just something's horrible going on with Douglas right now.
Sick?
Yep.
What kind of sick?
Just like some sort of horrible rash is taking over, and he's screaming, and it just sounds awful.
He's got a temperature?
I don't know.
One of Drew's kids is sick.
Mm.
Well, what do you do? What do you tell your wife to do?
I'll get home before I go to the hospital.
Really?
Yeah.
But what do you do in the meantime?
Well, we thought it was poison oak, but now it's starting to sound like something more serious. So.
Well, what could it be?
Toxic epidermal necrolysis.
Figure that out when you get there, right?
Yeah, but I better get going.
Well, you're good.
Take a couple calls, we'll go.
All right. Drew, you can get out of here.
I can?
I can ride the rest out. Look, so I got... What song do I got queued up there?
It's not really a good song to play now, though.
it's kind of negative. Stay here.
No, but just play the song. It's negative.
You want to hear In When I Die?
Yeah, go ahead. Yeah, it's blood, sweat, and tears. Drew, you can listen to it on the ride home.
All right, can I do that?
Yeah, go ahead. Drew's got to take care of his 10-year-old son.
Sounds like Sesame Street.
Wait, but let me tell you something. There better be something going on with that kid. I know your wife. She's a little nutty. You know what I'm saying?
Well, how are you going to feel if there is?
With certain feelings of satisfaction, but I will have mixed feelings about it. All right, buddy. Take care.
I'm not scared of dying, man.
That's ironic. That's kind of ironic song, yeah.
It's finally funny.
It's got the word die, like three words into the thing. All right, let's go talk to Laura here. Bring it down a little bit, Anderson. Laura?
Hey, what's going on?
It's cold way down there. Crazy cold way down there. What's up, baby doll? You're 21.
Yes, I am. I am and right what? In the thick of finals week here at college.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm getting a little bit of a panic attack. I don't know. It happens every once in a while, but I get so stressed out. I can't even concentrate when I'm studying, and I get so nervous. And I know Dr. Drew's talked a lot about when he was in medical school.
Tell me some of the symptoms of your panic attack.
It's just, I just get incredibly nervous. I get a little nauseous. Of what would be like how my final is going to turn out and that sort of thing. So I don't know. It just makes things difficult. And then
the worst that could happen if you didn't do well on your finals?
I don't know. I'd get below a 3.5. I can't deal with that. I know that
there ain't no hell.
Graduate.
Swear there ain't no heaven, and I pray there ain't no hell.
But I'll never know my living only by
dying will tell. All right, let's bring it down. Laura?
Yeah.
All right. You got to take, tell me one more. Tell me all your class schedules. What classes do you have?
This year I have accounting, processes, and controls.
Explain them all, please.
It's a whole bunch of accounting bullshit, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Annual
return of time. Yeehaw, yeah.
That's a lot of fun.
I see. And what else?
Then let's see. I have equity, markets, and securities, and that's about it.
No, that's about it.
Yeah.
All right. Well, you sound like you got a full load there.
Yeah, just a bit. You know, working 40 hours a week, it makes it a little more difficult. But
all right, babe. Drew gets these panic attacks too. I think he's having one now. You need to take a chill pill.
Yeah.
I'm no doctor, but I know when someone needs to take a chill pill. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Yeah. Those horns are heating up in a second, Anderson. Let's go, buddy.
Chill pill.
Bring it up now. Here.
Look out, children. Here it comes.
Here it comes.
Chill pill. Chill pill. Chill pill.
Don't wanna go by Satan. Don't wanna die uneasy. Just let me go naturally. Hey, Mike?
Yeah.
Drew, if you're listening to this on the way home, please take no message from it at all. What's up there, buddy boy?
Hey, man. I just want to say you guys... Sorry, Drew's not there to hear this.
Yeah.
It's going to be good. There's another band you guys need to check out. It's Chase. The trumpet player is Bill Chase. I think it's the same singer from Blood, Sweat, and Tears.
Do they sing that Get It On in the Morning song?
Get It On in the Morning.
Yeah.
That's what I'm talking about.
I know them.
You got to get Anderson to put that on.
Yeah, Anderson is...
this is the gayest music I've ever heard.
Barely playing this.
Gayest.
Yeah. Anderson likes the White Stripes and stuff like that because he's cool.
Yeah, well, that's cool, too.
All right, buddy boy. We'll see what we can do with that Chase. I'm going to get it going for Sunday.
Good deal.
All right, let's see.
What's next? I'm out of songs.
Talk to, I don't know what song. Yeah, skim through them. Let me see. I could hear Lucretia McEvil one more time before I went home. I got to be brutally honest with you, Anderson. Emily?
Yeah?
You're 27?
Chill pill.
Yeah.
You've been intimate, and what's your problem?
I never have been intimate with anyone.
You never have?
No.
Yeah. Well, you got to take a chill pill, baby. You know what I'm saying?
Chill pill.
Yeah, what's the matter? You're scared? Your dad left you? your band in?
No.
Mm-hmm. What happened?
Nothing has ever really happened. I mean, I have a lot of guy friends, but...
Oh, you've never actually had sex with somebody?
I've never even dated anyone.
You a big gal?
No.
Nothing's wrong with you physically?
No.
Guys ask you out?
Yeah.
And what do you say?
Usually I get to know them and they become friends. And
give us the top five reasons why you don't think you've ever been on a date with a guy. And go.
I don't really know. I know that if it gets to the point where they want to be more intimate, I kind of freak out.
Mm-hmm. Backseat Delilah. All right. So, you get along well with your dad. There's no sexual abuse, physical abuse?
No.
All right. So you really have no excuse, right?
No.
What do you do? Do you get along well with your girlfriends?
Yeah.
You're social? Everyone likes you?
Yeah.
So next time a guy asks you out, why don't you go with him? Yeah?
I don't think I can.
Why not?
Because it's like if they touch me and I just don't like it.
Are you sure someone didn't feel you up, like maybe even before you could remember it?
I don't think so.
Well, have you tried any therapy?
Well, yeah.
All right, try some more therapy. All right? We got to rock out here. What you gonna do? Yeah. Now, this is for Drew on the ride home. Your hair's all messed up, babe, and the clothes you wear just don't fit your ride.
Okay, so I know there's nothing wrong with me. So what's that?
So I was like, you always to think that these Dateline...
Godspeed to my partner, Drew, who's racing home to look after his ailing son. So he could not be here for the last 14 minutes of the show. But we had blood, sweat, and tears, so we didn't miss him. I want to thank Tara, don't call me Tara, goddammit, for doing a great job on the phones all week long. Brian, phone screener Brian, the only 24-year-old who's into blood, sweat, and tears. God bless Brian. God bless the child who has his own. I want to thank Junior producer Lauren for doing a great job in producer Ann's absence. And, of course, producer Ann for doing a good job when she's not in her absence. And finally, the magic fingered one, the Liberace of the potentiometers, Engineer Anderson, everybody, working overtime tonight. So, until next time, it's Adam Carolla for Dr. Drew saying mahalo.
Chill pill.
This has been Loveline. The opinions expressed on this show are not necessarily those of the staff, management, sponsors, or this station. The producer for Loveline is Ann Ingold. Loveline is a presentation of Westwood One Entertainment.